Hello, I'm Dr. Pradeep Kumari, a board certified dermatologist practicing at Pune since last 15 years. I truly believe in giving less medication whenever feasible. I also believe in finding the root cause of a disease and then treating it from there rather than just treating the symptoms. Hello, I'm Dr. Pradeep Kumari, and in this video, we continue our talk and discussion on vitiligo. In this video, I'm mainly going to go over the features of or salient points of vitiligo treatment. Treatment of vitiligo is always combined and never a single modality used because of the effect of the vitiligo on the psychosocial aspects of the person who is suffering from vitiligo. Vitiligo patches, which are very small or very few in number, can only be treated with some simple topical medications and cream applications. Usually, this sort of treatment, wherein we are not giving any oral supplementation or oral medication, is limited to one or two patches in children or post-trauma patches, and the idea is to stimulate the color as early as possible in these patches. People who are having multiple area involvement or large surface area involvement or are suffering from types wherein friction prone or trauma prone areas such as elbows, knees, lip and tip areas are involved in them, it is always a combination of topical cream applications, intake of oral medications and combination with certain other therapies, which can depend upon the availability of resources or economic aspects of the patient. Some of the simple but very effective advanced modalities available for vitiligo are light based therapies, something called as narrowband UVB, which is usually available in a doctor's chamber or in a doctor's clinic, wherein person suffering from vitiligo will go and stand inside a specific wavelength based light chamber, and the wavelength in this case is 308 to 311 nanometer. In simple terms, it is blue colored light. In situations and areas where this kind of narrowband UVB chambers may not be available, the advantage of nature is taken and the solar light is used to give some stimulus to the colored cells, and in such situations patient would be asked to ingest some light stimulating tablets and stand in the sunlight for 5 to 10 minutes on a daily or alternate day basis. Similar treatment for restricted patches can be done by just topical cream application and then exposing these areas to the sunlight, which can be done on twice a week or alternate day basis depending upon the sensitivity of the skin or requirement of the skin. Beyond this, for vitiligo, surgical modalities of treatment are also used, such as doing split thickness skin grafting or melanocyte suspension surgeries. It is very easy for a patient to jump to the thought or idea of doing a surgery once they have been diagnosed. However, vitiligo is an autoimmune disease, meaning our own immunity impacts the redistribution or the absence of the melanocytes, and surgery is only performed as a surgical way of camouflage, wherein we take patient's skin from a different area, non-vitiligo area, and implant it on the area of the depigmented patch. So there would be certain criteria applied by your dermatologist before doing surgery. The simplest and most common which you should know is that the spot on which surgery is planned should be stable in nature, meaning at least in the last 1 year it should not have increased or it should not have further depigmented. A surgery which is done on an unstable patch may not be successful or may lead to discoloration very soon after the color came back. Talking of treatment of vitiligo in unstable patches, there are still various advanced modalities available which don't require waiting for the lesions to become stable and can be started as early as detection of vitiligo so that the treatment completes fast and the results are better. Some of such treatments are excimer laser, needling plus 5-fluorouracil application, this is the name of a medication, and dermabrasion of certain vitiligo patches. These treatments don't require a prerequisite of stable vitiligo patch and can be done in very fresh patches also. Excimer laser in specific leads to rapid repigmentation and stability of the patches and is a very good modality. This we will be discussing in the next treatment segment video of vitiligo.